Kent Carson is a 55-year-old bank manager living on the outskirts of Chicago.
I'm responsible for all the employees, and I've always enjoyed working with numbers, and it fits my personality.
Banking isn't his only passion. He also has a loving girlfriend, Cheryl Johnston.
I met Kent 7 years ago. Kent has a wonderful sense of humor, and I fell in love with that instantly.
Both of us had been divorced, and we both were ready to start dating again, and it just seemed like it was a perfect match.
One evening in August, the couple are out on a date.
That evening, Cheryl and I had gone out for dinner on just a Saturday night, and we went to a restaurant, had a real nice dinner.
Everything was fine through dinner, but he started complaining that he was freezing.
I really wasn't too concerned. I just really thought maybe I just was sitting too close to the air conditioning.
I thought he was just cold from being in the restaurant and needed to warm up once he got outside.
The couple pays and return to Cheryl's house.
I got into the lazy boy chair and sat there and still was really cold. So she got me a blanket and I laid and rested.
Rest doesn't come easily.
One moment I'd be hot and the next minute I'd have the chills. Putting the blanket on, I was taking it off. I had an ice pack, putting it on, taking it off.
But he still had the chills real bad and I could see that he started to sweat. Kent is very healthy. He's never sick. So concerned me just a little bit. And he slept the rest of the night.
A good night's sleep does little to improve Kent's condition.
He woke up in the chair, and I could tell that he still didn't look well. He started to cough. There was a new symptom that he hadn't had before. I was starting to become concerned. I felt his forehead, and he was starting to burn up. So I took his temperature, and it was 102.5. I was worried about the fever. I gave him some pain medication and told him just to rest for the rest of the day.
Unfortunately, when I went to work, I really didn't start feeling any better. I still was achy. I still had a fever. So I ended up calling the doctor to make an appointment. Around 12:30, I start heading out to the doctor's appointment. And as I get about halfway out in the parking lot toward my car, I fall down. It was a little embarrassing, and I didn't know why I fell. I had a folder with some papers in there, and it was kind of a windy day. And I dropped the folder with all the papers, and the papers started blowing around.
Kent attempts to pick himself and his papers up.
And I took another step, and I fell down a second time. The same thing again happened. The papers fell and they started blowing. When I took a second step and I fell again, that concerned me because I was like, am I losing my balance or what? And I didn't understand what it was. And I just thought maybe it's because I'm weak. I scraped up the knuckles on my left hand. They were bleeding. And I didn't understand why I fell. And not only why I fell, but why I fell twice. So I had a feeling there was something wrong, but I didn't know what.
One of Kent's co-workers notices and rushes him to the hospital.
I was put on a gurney, and they had different nurses and doctors coming over and doing different tests on me. They took my temperature, they did the blood pressure, they took a blood sample, and they took urine samples, and still, everything was real kind of fuzzy. So that was starting to get a little scary.
Later that afternoon, Cheryl sits by her phone at home.
So on Tuesday, I knew his doctor's appointment was at 1 o'clock. So at noon, I sent him a text just to see if he was on his way or how he was feeling. I never heard from him. And 1 o'clock came and 2 o'clock came, 3 o'clock. It was a basket case waiting for his call. And finally at 4 o'clock in the afternoon, he called me. And he called me to let me know that he was in the emergency room and that they had given him an IV because he was dehydrated and they may be admitting him overnight. I was terrified. Nobody had given him a diagnosis yet. I didn't know what was wrong with him. I was hoping he was just dehydrated from the flu. It's terrifying. I was thinking the worst when Kent called me to tell me he was in the emergency room. I told him that I'm on my way. I was scared. A lot of things went through my mind. I could actually see our whole life together just flash in front of my eyes. I didn't know if I was gonna lose him, if they were gonna be able to save his life, because he was just going downhill quickly.
An hour later, tests on Kent's blood and urine come back, and they are positive for a deadly infection.
The emergency room doctor comes in and had determined that I had Legionnaires' disease.
Legionnaires' disease is a severe form of pneumonia caused by a dangerous bacteria called Legionella. Inside Kent's body, the Legionella bacteria invade the air sacs in his lungs. The immune system responds by producing fluid to flush out the infection. When the fluid builds up in the lungs, it can cause a severe cough and even breathing difficulties. The Legionella bacteria also cross into the bloodstream, contributing to Kent's chills and fever, and depriving his body of blood and oxygen. As the disease takes over Kent's body, the doctors have more bad news.
They were only giving me a 10% chance of survival. It's devastating. Your world comes crashing.
I was heartbroken. I honestly thought that's the last time I was gonna see him.
I was on 13 different drugs that were being administered through the IV.
Kent's body doesn't respond to the treatment as doctors had hoped.
I started to go down fast. They did some additional tests and I had contamination of the blood. It was keeping the oxygen from going to my vital organs, so my liver shut down, my kidneys shut down, my heart stopped, and they had to jump on the table and resuscitate me.
I prayed every second of every minute, somehow, some way, to pull him out of this.
To prevent Kent's vital organs from failing completely, doctors give him special medication called vasopressors that constrict the blood vessels and keep his blood pressure up.
By doing that, it took the oxygen away from the extremities. Within a few days, my hand and later my feet started turning gray. They basically told me I had gangrene.
Gangrene is the death of body tissue. When left untreated, it can quickly spread throughout the body and be fatal.
Oh, I was devastated. I thought my life would be over. And they let me see my hands and feet, and they were black.
If the doctors don't amputate the affected parts of his body, he will die from his spreading gangrene. Kent must choose between life and limb.
It was the toughest decision I ever had to make in my life.
Doctors wheel Kent into the operating room. There, the team remove his dead flesh. 2 days later, he wakes up to a horrific sight.
The Legionnaires had been cured, but a surgeon's removed my infected left hand and both infected feet. It was discouraging. I didn't want to be confined to the wheelchair and have to have people take care of me, and I didn't know if everything was going to be fine.
He was very depressed. He was ashamed because he didn't feel like the man he once was.
With the use of prosthetics and after 8 months of physical therapy, Kent finally makes a stand for himself.
I am actually walking. I started out with a wheelchair, then I went to a platform walker, and now I'm just walking using a straight cane. Most people today have no idea that I have no legs. I thank God every day for the ability to be here, and I'm making the most of it.